ശ്രീമാൻ വെങ്കടനാധാര്യ കവിതാർക്കിക കേശരി വേദാന്താചാര്യവര്യോ മേ സന്നിധത്താം സദാഹൃദി നമോ നാരായണ. വി വിൽ എൻജോയ് സ്വാമി രാമണാചാര്യാസ് വേഴ്സ് നമ്പർ 19 ടുഡേ ആസ് എ പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് അവർ കണ്ടിന്യൂയിങ് സീരീസ് ഓഫ് സ്വാമി രാമണാചാര്യ സ്തോത്ര രത്നം. സോ 19th വേഴ്സ്. ഉപര്യുപര്യബ്ജപുവോപി പുരുഷാൻ പ്രകൽപ്യതേ ശതമിത്യനുക്രമാത് കിരത്വദേകൈകഗുണാവദീപ്സയാ സദാ സദാസ്ഥിതാനോദ്യമതോ ദിശേരഥേ. സോ സ്വാമി, ഈവൻ ഇഫ് എവ്രിതിങ് ഇസ് ദർ, സം പീപ്പിൾ കംപ്ലെയിൻ ദറ്റ് ദേ ഹാവ് നത്തിങ് and they feel sad at all times. Being contented, having being joyful, being blissful, happy, that's what is required. Then you feel energetic, you feel happy. So you assume a person who is youthful and he has got good health, he is good looking, he has got good heart, good atma gunas, and he has learnt Veda Vedantams from Sadacharyan right from the childhood, and now he is able to even teach others. He is qualified to do that. Assume that he is in his mid 20s. He is able to do any activity energetically, enthusiastically, with over zeal, enthusiasm, and whatever he is able to eat, he can digest. He's got good arogyam. He is blessed by his elders. He has got samasta auspiciousness, asirvadams from elders. And he is firm in his mind, sattvika guna. He is able to get things done and he is able to do his work. And manas, vak, kayam, all act in unison. He has got good wealth. He is married. He has got his family, small family. He is able to live reasonably in a decent living. So with all these things, if you assume, and he is happy, he has got family, he is educated, he has got good gunas, he is kind hearted, he is blessed by elders, he has learnt Veda Vedantams, he is a good anushtatha, and all these things are there. And Upanishad says, when Upanishad attempts to explain that there are very many Kalyana gunas of Perumal, and Upanishad attempts to enjoy and explain in Anandavalli about Perumal's Anandam, Ananda guna, his happiness, his joy. Vijnanam Anandam Brahma Anando Brahme Divyajanat Anandatyeva Kalvimani Bhutani Jayante. When Taittiriya Upanishad Anandavalli tries to explain the Anandam guna of Perumal, it says, Asishto dhradishto balishtaha tasyeyam prithivi sarva vittastapur tasya purnasyat sayeko manusha anandaha. So it says, manusha anandaha. Assume a manushyan's anandam, which is what I just explained. This manushyan's anandam, who is in his mid-20s, who is educated, who is wealthy, who is healthy, who has got the elders' asirvadams, and he is living with his, he having a decent living, he has learnt Veda Vedantams, he is able to even teach others, and he is having a fulfilled life, and assume his joy and multiply that happiness which he has at that age. He is able to digest. He forget about us. We are not able to digest, we have not learnt, we are eternally unhappy, we crib, we talk, complain, all that thing need not be thought about here. A guy who is happy, blissful, contented, dhritishthad, and arogya, healthy. 100 times his anandam is teye shatam manushya gandharvanam ananda. So 100 times this manushya anandam is manushya gandharvan's anandam. 100 of that is deva gandharvam anandam. 100 of that is pitru, ajanaja devargal, karma devas, devas, devendra, brihaspati, brahma, chaturmukha brahma. So 100 times, 100 times, 100 times, like that, each one you have to multiply 100 fold. Then finally, sayeko brahmana anandaha. So finally, brahmana anandam, brahman's anandam would be attempted to explain if you multiply this manifold times. If that's the case about one guna, ananda guna, imagine infinite, most auspicious kalyana guna, samasta kalyana guna mridodati. That is why Veda is not able to explain the ultimate of Perumal's gunas, even Perumal. That's why Swami Desigan says, Nigamante adunapi mrigyamanam. Vedangalal innamum thedappattu varubavar. Still Vedas search for Emperumal. Nate Vishnu jayamano najato deva mahimna paramam antamapa, Rigvedam says. If like Chaturmukha Brahma, if a person has so much of the Ayush, and if the person has 1 crore, 10 million faces, and if he has got pure heart, good mind, sattva gunam, if there is a person with Chaturmukha Brahma's Ayush, with 10 millions of faces, and if he has got kind heart and sattva guna, good mind, and if he is able to explain Perumal's guna, Perumal's vaibhavam, he would not be in a position to even explain 1 millionth of 1 millionth of kalyana guna of Perumal. That is what it says in Varaha Puranam. Chaturmukar chaturmukayuryadi koti koti vaktro bhaven naraha kvapi vishuddhat chetaha sate gunanam ayutaikam amsha vadena va devavar prasida. So if we should think of that even 1 millionth with so many faces with Chaturmukha Ayush cannot be able to comprehend or describe Emperuman's guna. If all devas together praise for lakhs and lakhs of years, talk about Emperuman's guna, unable to do, says in Karna Parvam, Varshayutairyasya gunana shakya vaktum sametairapi sarva devaihi. So this particular verse, upariyupariyap, so the ever eternal Vedic doctrines and Upanishad like Taittiriyam, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, attempt to measure the limits of and boundary of each of your kalyana gunas and start to describe the anandam of from human up to Chaturmukha Brahma to beings of highest order. So when they say Manusha Anandaha, you can even start with Chaturmukha Brahma and then multiply 100 times. With multiplication of each Ananda by 100, you are not able to describe. So thus imagining 100 times, 100 times. So finally, the Veda is not able to comprehend or reach the ultimate. Yato vacho nivartante apra apya manasa saha. When the Ananda Guna itself is thus not measured, what about other gunas? There are infinite kalyana gunas of Paramatma. They are also immeasurable. Thus he is possessed with such innumerable infinite kalyana gunas of absolute infinite measure. Thus he is paripurnan. So one can even consider Brahma as human and start from Chaturmukha Brahma and multiply all these things. His swarupa rupa guna vibhutis, ananda, is elaborated here. Thus his swarupa rupa guna vibhuti is the reason for his anandam, which is infinite. So abjabhuvaha is talked about in this verse. Abjabhuvaha is dvitiya bahuvachanam. And Swami Desikan explains in Stotra Bhashyam, taking Katyayana Vartikam. So the Chaturmukha Brahma, from each Brahmandam, he is one. So even in Sri Vaikuntha Stavam, Swami Kurathalvan explains same thing, that Brahman's Anandam is infinite. Trayudhyaya tava yuvatva mukai gunaugaihi Anandameti tamieti samniyantum Teye satam twiti paramparaya pravritta naivesha vangmanasa kochara ityudaha. So the blissful state arising from the eternal youthfulness of Perumal and similar qualities is described right from human being onwards up to many stages of Deva, Manushya Gandharva, Deva Gandharva, like that each time increasing hundredfold, and the Swarupa Anandam is explained. The bliss quality enjoyed is presented in this wonderful Sri Vaikuntha Stavam. So Swami explains in Vaikuntha Stavam also this Anandam. So this Chaturmukha Brahma, he comes from this Brahmandam, he is different. So Rama Kupe Shwanantani Brahmandani Brahmantivai. When sage Margandeya witnessed on the little banyan leaf the reclining Lord from and Alil Alama Marathi Nilai Mel Uru Balagana Nyala Meru Mundan Arangataravinanayan. When he was reclining, sage Markandeya saw the little banyan leaf floating on the Pralayam waters, cosmic dissolution, during the cosmic dissolution, during the Mahapralayam. And on that water, the leaf was floating. And on that, the infant, the child, the baby was reclining. And inside his stomach, he saw the Brahmandam. And sage Markandeya must have seen everything that time. Andanam tu sahasranam sahasranya yutani cha ishchanam tata tatra koti koti kopya yudhani cha. He says Parasara in Vishnu Puranam. So there were very many andams, and then very many Chaturmukha Brahmas, and very many in that it's the pollen particles of the red lotus flower that comes out of the navel has got one Brahmandam. So when it rains, how much water droplets are on the mud, one can count the sand, but one can never count the Brahma, the Chaturmukha Brahma, how many of them disappeared or passed away, says in Ishavasyam. So Gangayaha Sikataha Dharaha Tata Varshati Vasave Shakya Ganayitum Loke Navyatita Pitamahaha. One cannot count the number of Chaturmukha Brahma that who had come and gone. So many of them. Acharya Swami Desikan takes this in Virakti Parvam and also in Ishavasya Upanishad Bhashyam. That is the meaning of Abjabhuvaha. Nalikena Spurita Rajasa Vedaso Nirmimana. Swami Desikan explains this in Bhagavad Dhyana Sopanam. Nalikena Spurita Rajasa. The lotus flower, from that the Rajasa, from that comes the Rajasa Gunam. From that comes the Chaturmukha Brahma with Rajasa Gunam. And how many? As many pollen particles as they are. So with that wonderful enjoyment of Anandam, the bliss of Perumal, let's end this. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Namo Narayana. Adiyai.